It's a very fine morning on the 7th of August 2018, and today marks the climax of the breastfeeding week, which began on the 1st of August. And Uganda joined the rest of the world to commemorate this week under the theme, Breastfeeding is a Foundation of Life. To share more with us on the issue of breastfeeding is none other than Monique Bazibu from the Ministry of Health, the nation under the Nutrition Department. Monique, most welcome.
Thank you so much.
Thank you so much. Bye. Now then, could you share with us what is the situation when we talk about the World Breastfeeding Week? Mm-hmm. What do we mean?
Okay, the World Breastfeeding Week is a week which was set aside for every 1st to 8th August of every year to make sure that breastfeeding is promoted, breastfeeding is encouraged, to at least make sure that mothers breastfeed to optimum required standards. Yes.
Now then, when you say mothers breastfeed optimally, what then, could you maybe tell us what is the importance? What is the importance of breastfeeding to a child and to the mother also maybe?
Breastfeeding has a lot of importance.
Yes.
That cuts across from right the person who is doing it to the person who is receiving it and to the others that are surrounding that those two people.
Okay.
And that is the mother, the baby,
and the family.
The father, the family, the entire family,
yes.
the community, then the nation at large.
Okay.
Once breastfeeding is not done, everybody is going to be affected. Now, like for a mother benefits from breastfeeding in such a way that she gets that attachment with her baby.
Okay.
Two, it is a kind of therapy that God created in her to making sure that it relieves her of the pregnancy stress and then the breastfeeding stresses and every other stress.
Yes.
Once the mother breastfeeds, this is where we get mothers when they are in their happy mood. A woman who doesn't breastfeed is a person you always get when her brains are off, she's always stressed because she's lacking something within her that really puts her to calmness.
Okay.
There is a hormone which helps a woman to be calm at that time when she's breastfeeding, such that the body produces breast milk. And then it is one way that God put into us to help us as women to be protected against the cancers of the breast,
okay,
the cancers of the ovaries,
yes,
but not any other person. To me, who is breastfeeding that benefits
when
from it.
You talk about any other person.
Yes.
You remind me what the Minister for State for Health General Duties, Sarah Pendi, said, mentioned recently in Parliament, that men are breastfeeding and they are taking all the children's babies. And the myth is that it cures cancer. So you mean to say the cancer that the breast milk cures is not the cancer in men, it's the cancer in women?
It is not really curing, but it reduces the risks.
And in women,
the person who is breastfeeding,
okay,
is the one who is benefiting from it.
Uh-huh.
But not a man, neither the other people.
Okay.
Yes.
Okay.
Then the benefits to a child. A child benefits in that she gets the care from the mother.
Uh-huh.
Our total care from the mother.
That the intimacy,
yeah, exactly,
that bondage, that...
It is created at that moment when the mother is being when the baby is being breastfed. Then the other is where we have that breast milk itself contains antibodies. These antibodies are very useful to this baby because the baby is born without the body being able to make its own antibodies such that it protects itself against infections.
Yes.
So the breast milk, God created it in such a way that it helps in having this breast, the baby being protected against particular infections, not all infections. Okay, the other point they are here in the importance of breastfeeding to this baby is that the baby gets protective properties from the breast milk. And among these protective from the breast milk, those salts that are going to help these baby's cells to be protected against infection is, let us say, the infection like measles. Mm-hmm. That's why we even, when we are at the facility, delay giving the measles vaccine, mm-hmm. because of the protective against measles within that breast milk from mm-hmm. the mother.
Yes.
So at least it is delayed until about 6 months or even up to 9 months. Mm-hmm. That is if there is no epidemic around.
Okay.
Yes. So the other importance is that this is a complete food for this baby.
Complete food.
Complete food
balanced
for the baby.
Balanced diet for the baby.
Exactly. That's the way you mention it.
Yes.
As a food, whatever the baby would require for growth, for development. Because when we talk about development, we are looking at this child's intelligence.
Yes.
The intellectual part of it is the one that we look at. It's all gained from the breast milk.
Okay.
Talk about the vitamins that you, as an adult, may not get. The baby is going to get it from the breast milk. Talk about the proteins you may miss. You, as an adult, the baby is going to get it from breast milk. So this wonder fluid from the mother was created in such a way that it is a complete meal for the baby, from water up to whatever the meal would be for a child, or the diet would be for any person.
So that means any attempt to deny a child to breastfeed well is actually suffocating their growth and development.
Exactly. And that is why once they are not breastfed, then you are setting off malnutrition in them. That is the start of malnutrition. Once the baby is not breastfed, then the start of malnutrition is at that point. Because as he grows, then he's lacking certain things that will help him to grow.
Okay.
He's lacking certain minerals that will help the brain to develop.
Okay.
Therefore, you are really deterring that person. Because though he's a baby, but he's going to become an adult.
Yes, yes.
You are deterring that person. You are denying that person the future to which he's going to base his life.
Oh.
Yes.
So when we say that breastfeeding is the foundation of life, this is what we actually mean,
exactly.
as per the theme for this year.
Exactly.
Okay.
Exactly.
Now, could you maybe share with us what is the situation in Uganda like as far as breastfeeding is concerned? I see we've had many, you know, achievements at least. I see, for example, at Parliament, there is a baby breastfeeding center and even other organizations.
Yeah.
Yes.
Yeah. That is true. But this is all initiative from the situation as it is right now as we stand. It's not really good because you find that it's only 6 out of 10 children that are exclusively breastfed.
Only six?
Only six that are exclusively breastfed up to 6 months.
So can you say only 60% of the children that we see who deserve to be breastfed well, only six of them
are
breastfed. The other 40%
are not exclusively breastfed.
Okay.
They are either mixed fed or not breastfed at all.
You see, corporate women, you mind your job more than the baby. You hear that?
So that's where now we are coming out to say there should be opportunity be given to every woman to make sure that whoever has a baby below 6 months should be given the time, should be given that opportunity to ensure that the baby is breastfed.
In that case, do you mean, for example, maternity leave should be, extended beyond four months?
Well, right now we are looking at 60 days of maternity leave and then the 4 days only for the paternity leave. But we are seeing that even these few days that are given as 60 days, they are really not so sufficient to making sure that the mother still practice exclusive breastfeeding. And given the situation that we are in right now, people are busy looking for money, but they have forgotten about the child's foundation.
Okay.
They have forgotten all about the foundation of the future generation.
Okay.
Yeah. And they are all, this is where we are looking at it as a compromise, yeah, to the future. Because you are looking for money, you are forgetting about the future. Here we are giving out an outcry.
You're compromising saying, the child's health.
Exactly.
Looking for wealth.
Exactly. And not only the child's health, but the population of Uganda.
Yeah, yeah.
The population
yeah,
of
actually,
Uganda.
40% of the children don't get the proper feeding.
Then
at
what
the
next?
Age.
Exactly.
Okay.
So here, that's why we are so much crying out to every organization,
yes,
every department within the government set up, everywhere, even parastatal bodies, all your factories, industries, to at least make sure they have breastfeeding breaks for the mothers. They have places in their workplaces,
special places yeah,
where these mothers can carry their babies,
yeah,
and then settle down to breastfeed these babies. Mm-hmm. And I'm telling you, a mother who has moved with her baby to the place of work,
yes,
will give you 100% performance than a mother who has left the baby at home, because all her mind
that's
will be at
very
home.
Important that although this mother is here physically working,
yes,
her mind is not on the job. It's on the baby at home.
Exactly.
But if you bring the baby, if you allow her to bring the baby at work, she'll commit herself to the job and she'll be happy because the baby is closer to her.
Exactly.
To yeah, I think that is a very good point to note for employers. That this woman, if you just don't allow her to come with her baby to the place, to the workplace and feed the child from there, then that means this lady is not giving you 100% output. As far as breast, as far as your job is concerned. So the best way to get as much as you want out of her is to allow them have their baby at the workplace, such that they can commit to themselves and they'll be sure that when they get that breastfeeding break, then they can breastfeed the baby and they work happily.
Exactly.
Very, very important.
So important.
Yeah.
Yeah. And besides that, breastfeeding should be initiated properly. If it is not properly initiated, then you are going to fail within the first 6 months to make sure that the baby is exclusively
breastfed. When you talk about initiated, maybe could you explain?
The initiation of breastfeeding is within the labor suit.
Uh-huh.
So the midwives who are there to assist deliveries of these mothers, the doctors who are there to support these mothers should make sure that the babies are put onto the breast within the first hour after delivery, regardless of what type of delivery, whether cesarean section or normal delivery.
The first hour?
The first hour is very important for establishing breast milk.
But now, for some mothers, I usually hear that they may take long to start producing the milk. So how can that happen?
Well, that is the thinking. But the breast milk is not a hollow organ where you feel that breast milk should be just poured. It's a factory. It has to manufacture.
Okay.
And then produce. So within the breast, there are cells that secrete breast milk. But how are they going to secrete breast milk? It's by stimulating the nipple.
Okay.
And then the body is sensitized that now it is time
to actually
secrete out, to leave out this milk.
Okay, that
to
has
flow.
Okay.
Because it is already made.
Okay.
As the woman is pregnant, there is breast milk in.
Okay, okay.
God wise. He made it. As the woman is pregnant, there is already a preparation for the coming baby.
Okay.
So that's why even now, we also prepare these women here externally and tell them, bring the clothes, bring this. But within the body, already the preparation is there. The baby is prepared for the feed.
Okay.
By the time the baby is out, he knows what to do.
Does that also remind the mothers about their nutrition during pregnancy?
That is true.
It's very important
where
to support this.
Mothers to are supposed to be supported.
Yeah.
Are supposed to be supported to make sure that they have good feeding during pregnancy, lest they may not have enough of the stores that will make the breast milk. Because the breast milk is made from the stores that are made at that time when the woman is pregnant.
Now, there are two situations as you look at the Ugandan situation. Mm. You talked about the other 4%, only 6%, 6 out of 10 children are breastfed exclusively, as it should be.
Yes.
What is the situation with the other 4%? What happens?
Now you find that the 3% are getting mixed feeding.
She's
breastfeeding and at the same time also being given other foods.
Uh-huh. When you talk of other foods, is it because, what could be the reason, what is the excuse for some mothers to feel that they don't have enough milk, so they have to bring in that other food as early as that?
From the experience we are getting from mothers, of course, they are saying we don't have breast milk.
Yeah.
That is the claim they make.
Yes.
But it's all about that they really do not know what to do.
Okay.
And indeed, for mothers, in most cases, do not know what to do. Well, people granted take it for granted that breastfeeding is like anything, since after all, animals can breastfeed. Who helps an animal to feed its young one? So this is the thinking that they have.
Okay.
So this is where we should come out of. Yeah. And we as health workers go in to support mothers. Tell them how to properly position the babies at the breast. And also properly attach the babies onto the breast. Because that is where the problem comes from. Once the baby is not properly positioned and not properly attached,
yes,
that is the beginning of the whole saga about low breast milk supply.
Okay.
Unable to breastfeed because I have painful sores. Mm. My breasts are hurting because they are swollen.
And is it true that this breast milk can actually, when you talk about those sores on maybe on the nipples, and any other infection that a mother may have, even to the baby, is it true that that breast milk can help to cure them?
It is true.
Uh-huh.
Just like I told you right from the beginning, the content or the constituent of breast milk, there is the antibodies,
yes,
and there is the anti-infective properties.
So the mother can take some and apply?
Exactly. Mm-hmm. And those wounds will heal.
Okay.
But to prevent all that, the midwife at the hospital or at the health center should ensure that by the time this woman comes to deliver, she knows how to attach the baby onto the breast.
Okay.
Because once you attach the baby poorly and you just give the nipple, this is where the baby is going to chew on the nipple. Many people think these babies' gums are soft. Mm. They are hard like your teeth. They usually bite.
The child is biting me.
yes, because remember this is a soft tissue. It is a delicate tissue.
Yeah, yeah.
And those gums are hard.
Okay.
And the baby, though we say is sucking breast milk, but he's suckling breast milk, implying what? That he's moving the gums and holding tight over the breast to squeeze out the milk.
Okay.
So in that motion, as it is done,
he's
biting you.
Okay.
Yes.
And that means some women could fear that, and that's the reason why they don't breastfeed for a long time. You know, 2-3 minutes.
That is a fact.
Uh-huh.
But if they are supported at the health center,
yeah,
I'm telling you, mothers will not have a problem. Where we have supported some of these mothers, mothers have had breastfeeding enjoyable with their babies.
No, you know, some mothers say they do this because they don't want their breasts to sag. You know, they want to remain beautiful. You know, they say, you know the situation that women say, they have to remain in shape. So breastfeeding after 3 months, no, they can't go beyond that.
Mm.
So is it true that they lose their beauty when they suckle the babies for too long?
Once beautiful, you will always be beautiful.
Uh-huh.
And one thing mothers and even the entire people,
yes,
including the men, should know,
yeah,
that whether you breastfeed or you do not breastfeed, the breasts will sag. Because as you were when you were a baby is not what you were when you were a toddler, is not when you what you were when you were a child,
yeah,
and is not what you are when you were a teenager.
Okay.
So as we grow, there is the degeneration of tissues. Those breasts have hangers.
They have hangers.
Those are ligaments. They are holding them.
Yeah.
But you are growing and they are loosening. Okay. So as they loosen, of course, the breast starts pointing down.
I can see.
Yes.
So it's not the baby that
it's
causes
not the baby.
Babies to sag.
Never.
The breasts to sag.
It's the nature, the development stages.
Okay.
Yes.
So for these 3%, that's where the problem is.
Uh-huh.
Eh? Yeah. Fear to lose that beauty that they say the men admired
uh-huh.
at first.
Yeah.
Eh? So in that case, you assure them that they'll not lose their beauty as long as they breastfeed. That's very, very important.
Yes.
Especially for our corporate ladies out there. You want to remain in the same shape.
Mm-hmm.
But they say, you can't lose that shape. Just give the child their rightful breastfeeding moment.
And when you are breastfeeding,
yes,
take it in the usual way.
Mm-hmm.
It shouldn't have all some kind of sort of things, because people are going on even to Googling, trying to find out how do people in India, in China,
yes,
in everywhere, how do they breastfeed? So they go on all trying of these things.
Yes.
Well, breastfeeding is breastfeeding, and it can't change.
Okay. It's universal.
It is universal.
Okay.
So we should breastfeed in the normal way, in the natural way.
Mm.
Because
there's no particular style.
There is no particular style. Babies should just be breastfed.
Yeah. Okay.
Yes. Provided the baby is properly attached
yeah.
and sucks out all the milk.
Yes.
Then the breast will make more milk. But if the baby sucks a
mm-hmm.
little like
That's another kid.
Uh-huh. A kid. Most people call their children kids. But
kids.
Me, I know a kid is for a goat.
Mm-hmm.
If you looked at the way a goat sucks, very fast, and it jumps off, and the mother kicks away. So if we breastfeed our children like a kid, then we are bound not to have enough breast milk.
Uh-huh. Okay.
Because once the breast is not emptied,
mm.
there is no more breast milk that will be made.
Generated, yeah, okay.
Because the hormones are starting to make breast milk when the baby is suckling. Because he's emptying those sacs, the stores, therefore more is being pushed forward to fill where it has been emptied for the next
round.
Feed.
Okay.
That is how breast milk is made.
So the child should empty
Yes.
that store or the whatever milk is there,
mm-hmm.
such that more can be
exactly.
generated. And I think we as men also have got a role to play in this, because if we get such information, then it means we can advise or
mm-hmm.
we can help our partners, you know, breastfeed in a better way. Mm-hmm. You know, one thing, assuring them that breastfeeding for a long time will not make them less beautiful as they were. That's very, very important for the men,
mm-hmm.
that your partner, your spouse, will not lose her beauty just because they are breastfeeding for long. That is as Monique has shared with us.
Mm-hmm.
And also, the issue of breastfeeding for a short while and leaving the milk there, it's very dangerous
mm-hmm.
for the baby and the mother.
It is so.
Okay.
And it is the very breastfeeding that is going to pull us out of the poverty.
Yes.
Because you making that money and feeding this baby on other things.
Okay.
But the money you are making, you are going to spend it in health care of this baby.
Okay.
Because the baby has not been protected.
Mm.
Two, you are going to use that money to buy feeds for this baby.
Mm.
But the baby who actually has already food, and yet that saving for the first 6 months would be really utilized optimally at that time when the baby has come to the time when he's supposed to feed. And that is after 6 months.
Okay.
Because after 6 months, the baby is now to feed on other foods.
Okay.
But you are using that very money to now feed the baby and at the same time taking the health care for this baby. Because a baby who is not optimally breastfed or who is artificially fed has many times of falling sick than a baby who is exclusively.
And I'm told even their level of intelligence, even in the classroom.
Exactly.
Their poor performance.
Exactly. And that's where you will be required to be getting into your pocket to pay for
coaching and tuition.
You pay for that coaching.
Okay.
Because you need your baby to be at the same level with these
others. With the others.
Yes.
Yet, at the earlier stage in life, we go back to the theme.
Yeah.
Breastfeeding is the foundation
of life. Exactly.
Now, as we wind up, we know the national celebrations are taking place today in Hoima. But before that, have there been any activities that we as Uganda have observed during the week such that they bring us to this climax, and maybe the sensitization that is needed has been maybe disseminated to the people out there?
Yes.
Yes.
Throughout the country.
Yes.
Even at wherever district levels, they have been going on to radios, sensitizing the communities. They have been going to local TVs, sensitizing the communities. People have gone as to the level of going to the health facilities to educate women who are pregnant and even to support those ones who are in labor to initiate breastfeeding and educate them on the importance of breastfeeding. Then in schools, that is the primary and secondary, there has been messages sent to these children, because if you want to educate a home,
yes,
first start with a child.
With a child.
So we take the message to these children, and the children have come up with poems. Reciting these poems is going now to help even the mothers learn about breastfeeding, because they are poems that they have recited. And as we are talking now, these are going to be recited at the bomber ground in Hoima.
Hoima.
Yes.
Okay, very good. Maybe as a last word, could you maybe share with us what message you have for the public out there that, okay, the week is ending, but does not mean that we should again put breastfeeding away until August 2019. We should always observe breastfeeding as per the experience and the advice that you've shared with us.
Yeah. Thank you so much. Members, it is everyone's responsibility to making sure that the child gets the good start, which is a foundation for his life and for the nation at large.
Okay.
If we want to come out of this, whatever outcries that we have, children are not, children are adamant, children are not, are striking everywhere, there is poverty here and there, there is all this mess that we are seeing in this new generation. We should go back to what it is, because when Moses was dumped into the river,
yes,
the daughter of Pharaoh did not think of going to buy the milk or to go and milk the camel, the horse, whatever he had within that, but had to look for a woman to breastfeed the child.
Exactly.
And we see what Moses did. Everyone who believes in God surely knows what Moses did for this world. And that's where we are, that we should go back to the old roads to seek for the foundation of the future generation.
Now, you know, when you talk about Moses, as we wind up, it means that the 11th commandment is that thou shalt not deny your child breast milk.
Exactly.
Very interesting. The 11th commandment, as for Moses, we can say that thou shalt not deny your baby exclusive breastfeeding.
Exactly.
And that is it for Urban today. Remember, the breastfeeding week is ending, but there's quite a lot that we need to share about breastfeeding. She has told us only 60% of our children are breastfed exclusively in Uganda. And that means we are sitting on a time bomb. In the future, we shall have 40% dull children. And who knows, even this number may grow if we do not correct the current situation. That is Urban Today.